will never pay you.
God Almighty.
Rejection makes us perform above God. Rejection will push you to perform. Rejection will push you. It'll push you to go over and beyond. And I am a father who wants to make my children proud. But my days of freedom came with a word called no. Y'all tripping over here. You all that don't have all the kids or don't have adult kids, listen. And I share my kids because I got awesome kids. My God kids, my kids, my grandkids, all of this wonderful people. But listen, you cannot do stuff for people based on how they will respond. How many of you do something for people and you just wait? You just wait on their response. You wait to see how happy it will make them. It's okay to make people happy, but you cannot be people's performance. Me and Lady God is saying, hallelujah, stuff that don't involve us, not my monkey, not my circus. Something be going on with folks, we're like, not my monkey, not my circus. Because people will invite you to the show and make you perform. They will make you perform. Let me get to the scripture. So, can I read y'all just a few signs of rejection?
Yes.
Okay. Number one, you question your value. You question your worth. You question your purpose. You compare yourself to others. You're cantankerous. You're sarcastic. Messy petty. You're a know-it-all. You don't value those around you, and you minimize their contribution to your life. You secretly compare, you criticize, and you despise leaders both spiritually and naturally. You're attention seeking. Can I get five people to holler right there? You look for affirmation, but verbally make statements about not needing it. You always need a circle or a backing in order to be honest. Oh, Lord, have mercy. You maintain a cycle of broken relationships. You give all relationships 100 in the beginning, whether you see signs of default or not.
Yeah. Talk about it.
Lord, I'm guilty of that. I'm guilty of a few. Some of these is by revelation. Some of these is by experience. Amen. Let me get to it because my computer not went out. Hallelujah. But rejection has a way. It has a way of trying to make you minimizing people's contribution to your life. Lord have mercy. You know, even that's one way that rejection really grows, because rejection, when it's operating through somebody else, they will never fully appreciate you because that spirit wants you to continue to perform. Oh Lord have mercy. Let me keep going. You ignore warning signs from God and those he places in your life. And you encounter somebody, you date somebody, you get connected to them. But instead of saying, God, I shouldn't go any further, you say, Lord, you got me. We call that fleeting the Holy Ghost. You only receive encouragements that make you look strong or gifted, but reject correction or admonishment that indicates you have a weakness. You're defensive, overly sensitive. You don't censor your thoughts. You retaliate overtly and covertly. That's for all you social media lovers. I submit to you that 75% of social media is retaliation. You're trying to send a subliminal message through the airwaves. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me, but I know. You find it difficult to compliment others. You secretly harbor resentment. You receive compliments. You don't receive compliments, Ray. You're paranoid. You're overly consumed that others are against you. How many haters could you have? I mean, really? You're overly confident. You're arrogant. You think more highly of yourself than you ought to. You cause others to perform rather than minister. You're secretly insecure. You're braggadocious. You embarrass the truth. You're jealous of others' relationships. You don't like sharing people or things. You're a hoarder. You're greedy. You hate to see your friends and family successful. Just a few. Rejection has a way of manifesting. When people, you always know when rejection is fueling a person, because when you correct them, they always have an excuse that will try to put on your emotions. They try to go for the jungle. You know, they try to throw that one line out that's going to emotionalize you, because rejection is lost in their emotions. So people who are fueled by their emotions, they think they can manipulate you by emotionalism. But we got to purge ourselves.
Yes.
Some of this is bringing awareness. Because what I do believe about this year is that when you walk in your manifestation and when you walk in your victory, your connections are going to be impaired.
Amen.
And I'm not saying that you can't walk with someone who is wrestling with the spirit of rejection. But what I am saying is, you're going to have to decide how close are we going to walk.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Yeah. How close am I going to let you walk in the circle? Because long gone are the days where you only tell people half your vision because you're afraid of what they're going to do with you. Love and mercy. Many of you cannot fully articulate your vision because you're around people you don't trust.
Come on, Apostle.
Make a decision. Do you not trust him because of you, or do you not trust him because of what God is trying to show you about him?
My God.
Yeah. And so Jesus did one thing. Look at the child. He did one thing. So the process of rejection is when I feel rejected, I feel like I'm not being received. And understand, rejection has no power. I see politicians with rejection. Mm-hmm. Major rejection. Anytime mm-hmm. people gotta always talk about what they did and not what they're going to do, that's the spirit of rejection. Anytime mm-hmm. people are talking, taking credit for something they did not do, that's the spirit of rejection at work. But this is what rejection does. I'm gonna show you the process of rejection. I'm gonna show you what Jesus did. I'm gonna let y'all come on, because y'all need to sleep. I'm gonna forget. But that's all right, because I took my mind in this morning. I'm gonna continue. So, Lady McGimson, I go over to her. I say, honey, you look beautiful. And she said, I don't look that good today. That's rejection. Because she did not receive the compliment I was trying to give. So then I walk over to my call. And in my mind, and in my spirit, and in my emotions, I begin to say, based on her response, that my compliment wasn't good enough. My husband is not good enough. My love is not good enough. So now I'm looking within based on her response.
Yeah.
Rejection makes you look at you based on what other people do.
Right.
Oh, Lord, have mercy. Lord, Judah scared me last night. He told me, he said, Dad, I don't want to major in psychology. I just, Lord, I about had a fit. I said, Lord, have mercy. I said, why you can't major in law? like, hey, you know, won't you be a lawyer? Won't you be a judge? Won't you, you know, do something with a whole lot of money? And he said, amen. I said, well, I don't have a whole lot of money yet. But then as I was writing, I said, listen, my response was negative because he has now revealed the way he's being bent. And I'm saying that's not good enough. But I ain't saying it based on what God has promised, like I said, based on my experience.
Yes.
And so I'm having to go back and think, how could this information he gave me, how is it going to affect the way he walks?
Amen.
Y'all got me?
Yeah.
Because see what rejection does is it makes you look inward and it makes you begin to compare yourself based on the person's response. And when you begin to compare yourself, hallelujah, God, what are you comparing yourself to? That's what rejection does. Negative, because some rejection is good. Some folk you need to not embrace. Some stuff you need not to embrace. Some people you need to walk away from. But I'm talking about when God has set you up in a relationship and you now cannot receive from people. You don't feel received. You don't feel loved. You don't feel embraced. You don't feel like people believe you. You don't feel like people value you. I had one spiritual son, he came in and he said he was getting ready to start a conversation. Well, he was going to leave the church. And so I knew the Lord had revealed to me what he was going to leave me about. So we sat out and we talked. And I was like, well, come on, son, come on with the car. I'm waiting for the punchline. And he said to me, he said, I made a post about you. Me and my wife made a post about you. And you didn't like it.
Oh, wow.
Jesus.
Wow. That's one of the moments where he said, okay. Holy Ghost, help me with it. You mean to tell me you're about to throw and walk away from a long-term relationship of travail, of improtection, hallelujah, of blood, sweat, and tears because I didn't make a conscious decision to like something on social media? That one thing spit you into a cycle that made you feel I didn't love you.
Jesus.
Y'all sit up in here, but y'all know it's real.
Real. Yeah, absolutely.
Because that one action made him look inward. And there's nothing wrong with looking inward. But when you look in, you've got to be able to see God.
Yes.
John 14:28. We're gone. We'll help you. Hallelujah. Hmm. John 14:28. Rejection makes you look within. Rejection of man, self-rejection, or fear of rejection causes a mental process that ignites self-evaluation. We are naturally set up to be interdependent, which means we are independent, but we also depend on each other. But rejection causes us to question our worth. And based on those thoughts, form an emotion. And based on those emotions, we react or act. But where is God in that process? You're looking within, but when you look within, do you see God? I'm sorry, John 14:8. Let's look at it and we're going home. Jesus is sitting with the disciples. He's sitting with the disciples. And one of the disciples asked him, when will we see God? When will we see the Father? Jesus' response is in with this. Verse number 7. If you had known me, you would have known my Father also. And from now on, you know him and have seen him. Philip said to him, Lord, show us the Father, and he is sufficient for us. You're hanging out with Jesus, and you want to see the Father. Basically, he told Jesus, your response is not good enough. We want to see the Father, and that will be sufficient. Jesus said to him, have I been with you so long, and yet you have not known me, Philip? He who has seen me has seen the Father. So how can you say, show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father in me? The words that I speak to you, I mean, I speak on my own authority, but the Father who dwells in me does the work. Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father in me, or else believe me for the sake of thy works.
Yes.
Jesus said, look, when I look within myself, this is how Jesus was able to make it through being despised, through being rejected, by being unimpressed by wrestling with grief. Jesus said, when I look within myself, I know the Father is in me. So every time somebody doesn't receive me, when I look within, I'm comparing myself to him and not their response. When I look within myself, I'm not saying that I'm not worthy. I'm not saying that I'm not good enough, because my temperament is the Father himself. My temperament is not the world. My temperament is not man's opinion. My temperament is not man's criticism. It's the fact that God himself is on the inside of me. So my question to you, family worship, is that when people don't receive you, when they don't embrace you, when they don't believe you, when they don't value you, when you begin to do your self-evaluation, what are you looking at? Do you have enough of the Father on the inside of you that makes you say, I'm not receiving that rejection, nor am I acting on it, nor am I responding to it? Because when I look within myself, there is enough of the Father to remind me that I'm fearful and wonderfully made in his image. There is enough of the Father to say that I'm loved by God. There is enough of the Father to say his grace is sufficient for me. There's enough of the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ that says I don't have to respond every time somebody comes up against me. I don't have to respond every time somebody doesn't embrace me. I don't have to act on the fact that everybody's not on my list, because when I look within, there is enough of the Father.
Yes.
Is there enough of the Father? We're going home like a trailer.
Yes, yes.
Amen.
Many of you have wrestled with rejection all your life. You can't just be saved and drunk. You can't be church saved. You gotta be full of the Father. You gotta be full of the Spirit of God. Rejection is going to come. Everybody's not gonna like you. Everybody's not going to receive you. They don't like the way you minister. They're not going to like the way you sing. They're not going to like the way you dress, the way you look.
Yes.
They might not like you, man. They might not like what you do. They might criticize you. But when you look within, is there enough of the Father to say, I don't receive these spirits? I don't receive these emotions. I want to see these negative thoughts that's trying to make me spiral down. I don't receive all these negative feelings that's trying to push me back in the car. Listen, many of you have acted out of your rejection, and it's been retaliation, because you didn't want to be backed in the car by people who were not receiving you. You got to be so full of the Father that all of your actions and reactions are in peace. If not, you'll never walk in success. Because success has to be handled. And when you have success, everybody's not going to like you. Everybody's not going to think well of you. Everybody's not going to like the way you do it. But you want to continue to go through cycles of defeat. If you feel like you have to respond to everybody's opinion, if you feel like you have to respond to the fact that everybody receives you or not, you will not. Nobody can win the masses. There's going to be somebody that don't like you. There's going to be somebody that don't receive you. There's going to be somebody that don't believe you. There's going to be somebody that don't value you. What do you think about you? You cannot handle what other people need. What do you think about yourself? Many of our behaviors are attention seeking. One young lady took me, she was like, sometimes I feel like you ignore me. I was like, I do. She's like, when I'm rejected at home and I need that from you all, I said, that's too much of a demand for me and your spiritual love.
Yes.
I'm not going to let you put me in that place. Or y'all not talking up in here. I will not let you put me in a place where you put a demand on me. And the people that's rejecting you at home, you let them go scot-free.
Yeah.
That's not fair to me. I don't have enough in me to know you are calling to the attention you need. My job is not to love you according to the attention you need. My job is to love you to a place where you feel the love of the Father.
Yes.
And that when you look in and you have to compare yourself, you are comparing yourself to the image he showed you about you.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Yes.
I have spent my entire adult life being a seraph. And I love being a seraph. I'm working on this memoir now called The Day I Took Work Home. I've loved being a seraph. But above all of that, being a seraph, it was not out of a pure place.
Amen.
Sometimes it was loving people because I wanted that type of love.
My God, come on.
Sometimes it was giving because I wanted to be given it. Even this morning, I said, before I deliver this word, I got to test myself. I probably sent out about 20 text messages. Friends, foes, and enemies. Just releasing the love of God. My test was, am I looking for a response? Am I just saying these things just so somebody can say it back to me? Am I just giving this love because that's what really what I want you to? No, it has to be based on the fact that within me there's enough of the love of the Father that I gotta disperse it. But even if I never get it back, I'm not gonna compare myself to what I didn't get. I challenge you today to deal with your rejection. This is my rhyme. I got a legal right in this man. I dealt with what's called rejection from the womb. My mama loved me as a mama's boy. Took care of her to her last breath. The way she had to carry me because of circumstances, I came here not feeling wanted. Every birthday till I turned 30, she took me my first birthday program. Feeling, every birthday, feeling, why am I here? I don't have to put a preacher in the pain of the world. Why am I here? What purpose do I have? And God said, you are a wonderful preacher, and you're a gifted prophet. But until there's enough of me, that every time you go to question yourself, you see me, you're never going to walk in the full fruition of your success. Because you're always mishandling the success based on people. Many of you in the realm of the spirit, you are a basket case because you feel the need to respond to every bit of criticism and every bit of, every time somebody like you or don't like you, every time somebody give you their opinion, it moves you like an Rubik's Cube. You're twisted and turned and provoked by all the people. And God is saying, I'm loving that you're going to be pushed and provoked by me.
Yeah.
When you move based on how people accept you or don't accept you, they have control. I command you to be free today.
Amen.
If you dealt with rejection or dealing with rejection on any level, that means you have negative mentality, emotion, action or reaction based on not being accepted, embraced, believed, or valued. I need you to hit the floor right now. Come on, move. In the name of Jesus, just come. Come on, tell God over yourself. I don't receive you any longer in Jesus' name. Rejection, I don't receive you in Jesus' name. I don't receive the thoughts you give me. I don't receive the emotions you give me. I don't receive the actions or the actions that you suggested for me to act on based on. Come on. Even the children, I got the children, take authority on yourself. In the name of Jesus, God, Lord, I will no longer think, no longer allow my emotions, no longer allow my behaviors to be dictated based on how other people feel about me. Jesus, fill me with your love. Jesus, let me see myself the way you see me. Father, fill me with your presence. In the name of Jesus, Father, we have a heart here. Under the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, over every believer in this room, that's on their face right now, that's on their knees right now, and that's coming out to me. Spirit of living God, we thank you and we praise you for casting out, come on, open up your mouth. We cast out every spirit of rejection, of self rejection, of fear of rejection, let those principalities are trying to move and influence their mind. Move and influence our heart. Move and influence our spirit. We cast it out in Jesus' name. What spirits of rejection do not cause people to feel devalued, to feel like they're not good, to feel like they're not loved. In the name of Jesus, we cast our principalities out. In the name of Jesus, we cast out every principality of rejection. Let's make people. Father, we corporately renounce the spirit of rejection that causes us to minimize our value, that causes us to minimize our worth. In the name of Jesus, Father, we say that we our self-image is built in you. In the name of Jesus, come on, right there where you are. Father, eliminate every believer, any behavior that we have that's been influenced by the spirit of rejection, any conduct they've had, any mentality they've had, any relationship that they've had that's been influenced, any connection that they've had that's been influenced by rejection. Lord, go down to the root. Even those that were rejected from birth, even those that were rejected from parents, those that were rejected by their spouses, their former spouses, Lord, any rejection that was brought on to them, I saw a leader the Christ is breathing in us now. Your body knows who's awesome in the and they walk away from you and make it feel children. We cast those spirits out of life in the name of Jesus. Not the parents who are rejected by their children. We cast them out now in Jesus' name. What was the balance of rejection? They're trying to make us think you're not lost. Father, we renounce in the name of Jesus. For God, God, and I am praying in the name of Jesus for those who have had loved ones to go back. And somehow we misinterpreted and begin to think that they no longer left us and go. That rejection that comes through separation. We renounce rejection that comes through separation. In the name of Jesus. Lord, even our skills of being rejected because we not blessed us with what we ask. Even when we misinterpret you, we are coming to you because you are manifesting the blessing. Oh, we let it go in Jesus' name. Rejection that was infused and still sinful behavior causes strongholds. We break it now in the name of Jesus. We break it now. Every behavior that attempts to fill a void on the inside of us, that only your presence can reveal in Jesus' name. So together we say, Father, heal us from all rejection. Let the blood of Jesus heal us. Jesus has already conquered rejection. And so will we. We renounce rejection. We renounce fear of rejection. We renounce self-rejection. In the name of Jesus, come out of us now. Come out now. Come out now. Come out now. In Jesus' name. We love you, get ready. You're upon your feet just to begin to worship God. Yes. Yes. Come on, get up and worship. Come on, get up and worship.
Yes,
yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, Yes.
Thank you.
but for the real truth. Will not be moved, influenced, or contaminated by rejection. Will be no fulfillment in the power. And so, Father, we give you permission to illuminate any character, behavior, any mode of operation, any cycle of behavior, whereby we operate under rejection's influence. And we say, Lord, we not take our condemnation to any behavior that He illuminates to us. But Father, with your strength, we will combat these behaviors. We take that control of our mind. We take that control of our emotions. And we take that control of our behavior. Jesus. And Father, we thank you for loving us.
Yes.
So in this moment, we receive that love. Thank you for loving us. Even in the behavior that your love was not. Thank you for loving us. In Jesus' name.